Är du en duktig ung gäddfiskare som vill vara med på Kanalgratis YouTube-kanal? Nu har du chansen att visa vad du går för. Kanalgratis.se presenterar Pike Hero. Uttagningen kommer ske på Sportfiskemässan i Älvsjö 18-20 mars i Kanalgratis monter. För mer information, gå in på www.kanalgratis.se/pikehero eller klicka på länken. Vi ses på Sportfiskemässan och du, tävlingen är på svenska men textas på engelska. Äventyret börjar här.
Hello everyone and welcome back to another session of Perch Pro. For the second time we will follow four teams with Sweden as battleground fighting for perch fishing. Before we start, let's do a quick interview and see what has happened on the starting field. First team out to be introduced to this session of Perch Pro is team Vision.
Yeah, Vision Fly Dressing.
Welcome Stefan, Jensen and Daniel Bergman.
Thank you.
Fly fishing in Perch Pro, really?
Yeah, we would like to think that will work. But we know it will work.
Did you do any training?
Yeah, we did quite a lot of training.
Did you do well on your training?
Okay.
Earlier, Daniel Bergman stated in the Kanalgratis live show that he would shave his beard if he won it or...
Yeah, I'm starting to regret that, but we'll see.
You worked hard on that beard, man.
Yeah. It's been there for a while.
So what do you think? Top water fishing? We got low pressure and stuff.
We got crappy pressure. Everything is just falling down. So I think we have to dig deep.
Aren't you afraid you won't be able to catch up with the number points as all the other teams can, you know, do 10 casts when you can do one?
Well, we're not even going for numbers. We are going only for big fish. So, Yeah, small fish doesn't interest us.
That's a nice game plan. We will follow you closely. Moving on to Stockholms Fiske and Fritid, who was in the tournament last year, lost the first place due to draw point situation. Very bad. There's also been a change in the team setup. Yeah. Tom, would you like to introduce your new friend here?
Yeah, this is Linus Ronesh. He also works in my shop.
He's a colleague.
Yeah, it's time for him now to try it out.
Where is Stefan?
Stefan is at home resting from last year. He's tired of all the perch we pulled up there.
All right, so Stockholms Fiske were criticized heavily last year because they caught like 3,000 perch in 3 days.
Yeah.
And they gave us the reason. You guys were commenting a lot and everybody was talking on that there should be a length measurement restrictment. So therefore this year we have a new rule, which is 25 centimeters is the minimum measurement for approved fish this time. Tom, I mean, do you even have a chance now?
Oh yeah, we'll show you.
You're going to show us. How did you warm up?
Nothing.
No warm up?
I work, so I don't have time.
What about, I saw on your Facebook last night, there were like, you know, some big perch there. Are they from your training session?
Yeah, one training from last day, weekend.
How big was your biggest perch this year?
1.8.
1.8. Whew! Yeah. All right, nice. All right, welcome to the show. We will watch you closely. CVCF Fishing Team. Albin, Sharghi, Stefan, Trumstedt, veterans to this format in Kanalgratis. And back again, fighting for big perch. Last time got burned. And Albin, Sharghi, have you been training?
Yes, I have. A lot. I've been working hard.
What about this weather? We got a temperature drop. We got a low pressure curve coming in that is going to mess things up for everybody these 3 days. How are we going to handle that?
I'm going to fish as I always do. I mean, you have to change as the weather is changing, of course. You have to change the strategies. Go slow, go deep, whatever. We need to find a way to find the big fish, and I think we know where they are, but we just need them to bite. But as soon as this pressure will stabilize and a bit warmer weather will come, maybe these days, we'll have some big fish.
You're waiting for changes and try to adapt to the situation. Stefan Trumstedt, do you follow your colleague's strategy on this?
Yeah, I do. It's the same for everybody, and you know, you can't do anything about the weather.
All right, looking forward to it.
I'm pumped up. I promise.
Pumped and ready to go. All right, so let's meet the final team before we roll out. Welcome to this tournament. This is Frédéric Jullian, and this is Thomas Engert from France and Germany. And I'm going to start over here with Thomas. Thomas is an international angler who is competing in different sorts of tour out in the international market in Europe, and also very known for black bass fishing. Would you like to tell us a little bit about black bass?
Yeah, of course. We have a black bass team in Germany. I'm the captain of this team, and we participate now 7 years. And we had two titles, two bronze medals. What I find is very nice. Of course, we don't have a black bass in Germany.
Are there any similarities from black bass fishing to perch fishing? Can you use any of that knowledge?
You can use some of the knowledge, but they are different.
I heard they're very, very tricky, black bass.
Sometimes very tricky, and sometimes they bite like crazy. It's every day is different, and you need different colors, you know. Some colors work when the sun is more up, and some colors work when it's more dark. You have to try out during training what they like, and you have to change constantly baits during the competition.
So how did you train and warm up for this session? I know you arrived in Sweden just a couple of days ago, I think.
Yes, I warm up together with Fred. Fred was here 1 week more, so I was not completely in the dark, you know. So I trained 2 days and it was okay. We saw a lot of spots and tried to catch some fish. Even the weather is bad now. If plan A don't work, we change to plan B or C.
Fishing together with Frédéric Jullian, who is very well known in Sweden by now. And you have prepared for this thoroughly. I have followed you closely. Do you feel comfortable going out now?
You know, it's fishing, so I never feel comfortable. Every day is a new day, and the fish rules. I mean, it's they decide to bite or not, and we can just try to understand how to make them bite. And so it will be new days every day, and we are just confident because we think we found a few plan to follow, and so we can switch from one to another one. And I've been spending a few weeks in Sweden extra this year, so to get ready and get prepared. So we feel confident anyway.
I need to get one of the most important questions that we're gonna have in the commentary threads out of the way quick here. How fast is your boat?
Fast enough to go on the spot, you know, it's just...
I heard you got a visit from the Coast Guard yesterday.
Yes, they are very interesting in the boat, and it's going fast, and suddenly they say, oh, what is this boat for? So I get questioned for the tannon, I get questioned for how fast it is, how powerful, and the first one we get control, they even race and was controlling the speed we was, and was surprised that we speed up so much. But it was really a cool thing, and we get open discussion with them, but none of them were fishermen, and they was not able to help us, so.
You asked them for fishing spots?
Yes, of course.
They must know the best ones.
Yes, but they didn't tell us.
Okay. What do you think about bait sizes when the pressure is going up and down? Upsizing and downsizing, I mean, we do it for predator fishing for pike and stuff, but in the perch field, is that something that you will use and think about?
Yeah, same thing as every predator, in fact. It's, we saw it already during the training. From one day to another one, we could fish with 10 centimeters bait. And the next day on the same spot, you have to downsize. And it's really up to the days and what they are chasing. There's at the end of the summer, you get all type of bait, all type of size. And so they are opportunist. If they found a good shoal of 10 centimeters bait fish, they will feed on that. And yesterday we get a good experience on really tiny live bait that they was chasing on. And I even get a big asp as a surprise, and that was really fun. But they was chasing yesterday on really tiny bait, and that was quite a big problem. I would prefer that they feed on big bait.
I see what you mean there. Fantastic. And Frédéric, Jullian and his team is taking this very seriously as they brought their own boat all the way up from France to join this tournament. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to wrap things out and start this competition. Four teams, eight anglers. This is Perch Pro.
The competition is started, and now the teams have 3 days to go wherever they want in order to catch as many and big perch as they possibly can. It's going to be a tough fight. Tag along.
Face to face, eye to eye, under lights nowhere to hide. Mask of steel, silent words, waiting till the coin is turned.
On the road again.
Yeah.
Lovely weather.
Yeah. This is going to be hard.
Yeah, but it's the same for everyone. This year we're planning to go south, way down south, and actually gonna take a couple of hours driving, get some new experience for me at least. Linus has been fishing there before,
yeah,
but I never ever tried that water. So
Stockholm's Fiske is heading south to the archipelago of Småland and are taking a big risk as it's going to take several hours to get there. Although, it's an area known for big fish, so let's hope they get rewarded by some feeding lunkers when they get there. The rules are simple. The teams are free to go wherever they want to fish for 12 hours per day for 3 days. 1 point is given each day to the team with the most qualified perch caught, and 1 point is given to the team with the biggest fish. If two or more teams have the same number of points after 3 days, the winner is determined by which of these teams have caught the biggest fish during the competition. All teams have to be back at the Stockholm Fair before 9 p.m. the last day. Otherwise, one penalty point is given to the late team. Now, let's check what Team Vision fly dressing are up to.
Follow that car!
So, we're going a bit further up the coastline. Outside Uppsala and stuff, we know some good areas there, and it's gonna be better weather.
We hope so.
Yeah, according to the forecast, it's better pressure, no rain and no wind.
They're going straight, but we are going here.
Yes. Okay, bye-bye, guys.
So they're going south.
Yes, Stockholm Fiske seems to be going south.
Fuck off.
We have planned it well this time.
Yeah.
No stress for every gear is in perfect shape and
yeah.
So on.
Yeah,
so
more prepared and doing a little bit of a twist this year.
Yeah.
It's going to be awesome as always. But it's really cool to see the fly guys and Frederick and Thomas see what they're up to.
Yeah, or,
of course we're not going to see it, but we're going to have a hint
tomorrow. I saw Frederick when he saw our boat.
Yeah.
You know,
He was kind of losing it.
Oh,
yes.
Shit.
Yeah.
Everybody.
Yeah.
You know, because we have so small engines, so
yeah,
they know
that we're going to a small place.
In small areas.
I think the CVC team with a small boat, they go on some private
lakes.
Yeah, private or at least small lake with boat regulations.
Going to a small lake, which we are,
yeah,
as you might have figured out by the size of the boat, is for us, I think it's more easy when the weather is bad because the fish can't go anywhere. Of course, they won't bite maybe, but we know that they are there. We know the spots that the fish will pass sooner or later or just rest on. So we always have the chance to catch the big ones. On the big lakes, in these weather conditions, I think it's really hard because they can spread out. So, we'll see.
Well, that was some interesting thoughts, Mr. Sharghi. Now let's hear how Team ILLEX Gunki are going to tackle the falling air pressure in bad conditions.
We're gonna fish downtown. We have this vertical structure, and they can come up and down very easily, so they stay all year on the same place.
Very interesting. Frédéric Jullian and Thomas Engert are looking for underwater vertical structures for the perch to hide due to the bad conditions. And where would be a better place to find them than at the central parts of Stockholm with its many bridges? Let's do some urban fishing.
Let's go!
Let's stay under the bridge.
Yeah. Well, that's a cool thing, fishing downtown. Urban fishing. We can hide under the bridge and get dry.
Yeah. Also the perch, when it's raining, they hide under the bridges.
Yeah.
To don't get wet.
So they don't get wet.
So it's 7:30 and we start.
Yeah, first boat, 7:30. Let's go for 12 hours fishing. Hardcore fishing.
Hardcore fishing at its best.
Did you get any result one day with a top water under the rain?
Yes, of course.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. Ooh. Ooh.
You see, top water is working in the rain as well.
The first fish of Perch Pro Season 2 is caught, and on a popper of all lures. That was a bit of a surprise.
The time is now 7:30 and we've traveled a bit up north. And up here it's no rain and no wind, so far it actually seems like...
Our plan is working.
Yeah, hopefully.
It's going to be really interesting to see the other guys because I got a feeling that they're moving into bad weather. Everybody turned south from the highway.
Except of us.
Yeah.
We've checked the whole of Sweden like 10 times yesterday.
And yeah.
I mean, this is more or less the only area in the whole of Sweden where we would have, proper weather.
Yeah, I think I see the Stockholms Fiske.
Yes, they're behind us.
I think that's
now we're south of town. Normally they should go north if they're going to fish their home water. So I think I know what they're up to. That's where we caught this big perch this spring, 1800 grams, 1.8 kilos, and a lot of other big fish. But I mean, the fishing in the coastal region is very tough this time of the year. We just decided to trick Stockholms Fiske and Fritid. So we
turn off from the highway
down for Sibbo Lake to trick them into thinking that we go into Sibbo instead. But now we're going to go up on the highway again. But now it seems that the road is closed, so now we have to take a detour.
I can't believe this. I can't believe this.
Here, Fira Syd.
We saw that the CVT team were turning off to Lake Sibbo. So I think they're going to have a real rough day on the water with that small boat. Because I think the wind direction is right into the Sibbo Lake. So. Can be quite rough.
Oi, oi.
Fresh.
Gick han in på toan? Kärring. Vilken kärring.
Sitter du ner och pissar också, eller?
Oj, oj, oj.
Come on! It's perfect!
Det är bra så!
Mål! It's okay!
If you go in the back, don't slip.
I'm gonna have a tracker on me! Ah, shit! Come on!
Mycket vatten, a lot of water.
Shit. Jag får ju allt.
Vänta.
All the water is coming out. Just a moment.
Well, it might be a good idea to remove the water from the boat before you put it in the lake. So that's what Stefan is doing right now. By the way, have you ever seen someone trying to carry a boat down some stairs? Watch closely.
Jesus Christ!
Is it cool? I'll help you. I come down. There we go.
Whew.
Oh. Kommer lite snett där.
Fan, jag åkte ju ner med hela jävla skjuttan.
Ja, jag med.
So Truman, how would you describe your morning so far?
Good start.
All ways are good except the bad ones. Let's see if Team Vision fly dressing have a smoother boat launching technique. Wait a minute. What did Mr. Bergman really mean there? Let's have a replay. Okay, then we know.
It's okay. It's okay.
Woo! What are you doing?
Hilarious!
Well, you need to unhook that one as well.
I think so.
Next time we could just stop the boat without jumping in it.
There was point of no return.
So far, very little activity as we could expect with this cold weather coming in. But we saw some fish, we get a fish on a live well. It's not much, but that means that the fish stay on the place. We just have to adjust our technique. So far, we was fishing quite fast, really to get the first information on the spot. And now we are changing to some more slow and deep technique. So I'm going to first go down the weed with a Texas rig. Yeah, I use a shad, a glossy shad from ILLEX. And we're gonna see what's happened a little bit underneath the surface. It's a solid one. Whoa. The net.
Good one.
Ha! And look at this.
Woo-hoo. Completely inside the bait. Completely inside. So, sorry Fred, but I have to go on.
Yeah, please.
It seems like Team ILLEX Gunki have a problem. They have left their digital scale in the rain, and now when they need it, it stopped working. How do you plan to solve this?
There's a shop just near. So if then I just go in the shop. We didn't think about the backup on this one.
No.
So now it's 9 o'clock. We have a total of 6 good fish. Nothing really big, but 6. Go to a fishing shop, get another scale, and we'll see. Let's go, move.
Very, very bad. Now Frederic and Thomas lose highly valuable fishing time that they would need to gain numbers and wait before all the other teams hit the lake. Vision fly dressing are on the water and are heading towards a small closed cove far out in the archipelago, usually a very good kind of place for finding big perch in the Baltic.
We went into this small cove and I found a nice perch without even casting the first time. Will you net it? Oh, thanks, buddy.
It's in the bag.
I just flipped the fly out a few meters and I got this baby. First cast. Nice, good start.
Yeah, well done. No comments. No comments. We just hammered a rock. Seriously, fishing team, did it again.
Actually, I'm shaking here. It's so exciting. You know, we had just started fishing and I had some small bites. First cast and second cast, a pike took everything. So feels like they're biting. You feel anything out there?
Nope. Had a small bite. Just a nibble.
The time is 10:36, and finally Stockholm's Fiske have hit the water. Let's see how they're doing.
So we had some breakfast, and now we're heading out in the real windy and stormy weather to try to get some perch. I already thrown out my first cast, and the competition is on. The wind is really bad.
Shit.
It's really hard to feel what you're doing, but what can you do? Just keep on hammering those baits. Try to get the line as low as possible.
Oh yeah, fish on.
Okay. Okay.
Fish.
First fish of the day. Quite nice.
Well,
no problem there.
Okay.
The fish seem to be biting hard and small in. And Stockholm's Fiske gained 2 perch in the first 2 casts, also resulting in a new top fish so far in the tournament, weighing in at 0.9 kilos. This gives them 1 point for the biggest fish, while Team ILLEX Gunki still have the number point. But things are moving fast.
Oh, that's a better fish.
Yep.
Weigh it. I have to click. You have 3 fishes now.
Yes.
Finally, Team ILLEX Gunki have found a tackle shop looking for a new scale. The clock is ticking.
Now it's 11 o'clock. We are back on the water. We had to go out. Of course, we have had to buy a new scale. Our scale was broken. Now we are back and try to find the perch in the shallower water. We lost a lot of time. This could be a... Oh.
Ah!
You had a bite?
Yeah.
Me too.
A spot lock.
Tok tok.
Spot lock. I'm going to switch to a blade.
I cannot see any action.
It's 11:15. It's 11 o'clock, and this is the first one we've caught. First fish over 25 centimeters. So we'll see. It's going to be interesting by 12 o'clock when the report is coming in. Stefan is stuck, so I'm going to help him to get the bait loose. But we're fishing over a rocky area, like a point that comes out from the shore, and it transcends down to maybe 8 meters, but it's 3 meters on the top. That's where we fish, and it's a spot where we've landed big fish before. We only had some small ones. I'm fishing the Carolina rig with a small ribster, and Stefan is fishing a Carolina rig with a bigger bait, and sometimes he picks up the traditional jigging rod trying to fish a bit more aggressively. So we're constantly trying to find out what they want, and now they wanted this one.
We gotta fill in our numbers for 11 o'clock. Daniel, do you have?
I have 3 qualified.
3.
And biggest.
Got 1. Wow. So that's 4. Total sum of 4. And what was the weight of yours?
0.42.
Let's go again.
Trying to the deeper area. See how that goes.
No, oh, fuck.
Strike.
Okay. It's a better one.
It's a hard one. Oh, fuck.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, hope.
This is what came up.
pretty nice.
Yep. One more. Number six. The wind is turning all the time, so it's...
I think the technique you have to do is wait until it...
It touches the bottom, exactly. I know. I noticed that.
It's no wind whatsoever. It's warm. And this far, no rain either. Pretty sweet.
Well, then it looks... Look at it. It looks like it's raining, but it's just minnow, just bait fish all over. So there should be a chance for some action.
Since we have such extremely dark water, I think I'm actually gonna put on something like a smaller pike fly or something.
Yeah, and also because of all the bait fish, it might be easier for the perch to find your fly.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, the amount of bait fish is
something too.
And I'll say it's ridiculous.
That doesn't look like the other guys. You can compare it to the other guys there. It's easier to see this one. I would eat that if I was a perch. We'll try.
Oh yeah, fish on. Fish on. We have a very good size of all the perches we have to catch. I think this guy is one of the smallest for today, and this is number 10. This one has some worms on. That means that they're standing on the bottom. Mm. Just waiting for my jig to come. Okay, number 5. That's fantastic. Even though the weather is so bad with rain, hard winds, they're biting like crazy. Last perch for before the first report of the day. Oh yeah, it seems to be quite nice. You got the net. Oh. Come on, buddy.
Yeah.
Yeah, this one we're gonna take some weight on. This took on a Gunki grubby shad.
Red Ghost.
Red Ghost is the color of this. And this is absolute perch candy. It's been, oh, nice one. Oh yeah, look at that. So it's 1 kilo, exactly. Very nice fish. Look at the colors of the fins. They're so beautiful. And it's been a fantastic day though to the weather conditions, because all the perches has been in real nice shape. Okay, I have to make a click on that one. It was number 26.
So now I'm gonna try this like jig fly with a sculpin head, some rubber legs, and a wicked taste.
Good fish here. Feels heavy. Oh, the head shake looks good. Yeah. Yay! That's a good fish.
That's a better fish.
Yes.
It's not a monster, but it's a good fish.
Yes. Wow. Nice, buddy.
Oh, the fly's out.
Fuck yeah.
4.6, so far the biggest of the day, but we'll release him and get a big one.
Whoa. Okay, this is CVC fishing team. These are our results. 2 fish over 25 centimeters caught. Biggest one, 0.3 kilos.
Hi, and this is Daniel at Fly Dressing. We got 5 fish over 25 centimeters. Biggest one, 0.46 kilos.
Okay, this is Gunki, Frédéric speaking. We have 7 fish so far, and we didn't weigh any of them because we think nothing more than 400. So, 7 fish so far.
Okay, this is Tom from Stockholms Fiske team. We have 26 over 25 centimeters and a top fish of 1 kilo.
Okay, thank you very much. Yeah. Goodbye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye bye.
Bye.
Okay.
And I heard a whoops from everyone.
Okay.
Oh, that's good.
Okay. So, fly dressing. They have 5 fish.
Yeah.
And biggest is 0.46.
Yeah.
Gunki, they have 7 fish. Biggest one is 0.4. And Stockholms Fiske, they have 26 fish, and biggest one is 1 kilo. That's really good. So they have both the points now. I mean, that could change really quickly because, I mean, difference between 7 fish and 26 fish is not that much when it comes to these small fish, but
no.
A kilo fish is good.
Kilo fish in this condition.
And also they were, I think they were driving very far, so they can't have been fishing for a very long time.
No.
So they have a good spot. And maybe that kilo fish was only a bonus. We don't know about that, but they're certainly in a good spot.
Yeah, but that's nice.
Yep.
That's nice for the competition.
Yep.
Now we must put another gear in.
Yeah, put the gear in. Pedal to the metal.
Okay, okay, Abbe.
Let's do this.
Yeah, we do.
Yep.
Watch us.
Tom, 26 fish, 1 kilo the biggest.
No.
Vision, 5 fish, and CVC, 3 fish, 300 grams. I guess he's fishing Malaren, but I'm not sure. But he should fish the lake, the same lake as we have. But
better spot.
Hmm?
Well, that was sort of encouraging. Yeah, yeah. I thought we would be crushed, but
we haven't been fishing that
bad at all.
No, not that long.
No, no, true. And if we,
we're actually second biggest.
Yeah. And since Gunki probably is in Mälaren. They got 7 fish and probably longer fishing time than us, so.
Oh yeah.
That's good. So Stockholm got 26 perch and biggest 1 kilo. They're very close to getting 2 points today. So I don't think we will be able to catch that amount here.
Oh no, we're not. But we're not here to catch an amount.
No, of course. But let's break 1 kilo. That's what we need to do.
They could actually win the competition on the first day if this continues.
Yeah.
Let's go up here and stop them.
Yeah. Yeah. We stopped them with the big eye whistle on the sonar. Yeah. That was.
That's a big fish.
Yeah. Okay. Right. Let's do it.
Okay. We're way ahead now, so we're just gonna keep on hammering, and we're gonna give them some real bad numbers and bad weights too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. High five.
High five.
Okay. This is action fishing.
That's my comment.
Okay.
I'll put that in.
Okay, shit also.
Yeah. Yeah, do a little rumba for me.
Okay, so
okay, let's
now perch fishing.
Now we put down to zero again.
Yeah. Just hammering.
And now we're gonna show those guys how to fish.
Trash talk.
We're halfway into day one, so let's have a look at the current scores. Stockholms Fiske have the top number with 26 perch, while all the other teams have less than 10 fish, giving Stockholms Fiske the number point. Looking at the big fish results shows that Stockholms Fiske also hold the big fish point by great margin with their top fish at 1.0 kilos. Overall, the scores are 2 points to Stockholms Fiske, 0 points to Fly Dressing Vision, 0 points to CWC Fishing Team, and 0 points to ILLEX Gunki. And you gotta remember that Stockholms Fiske have only fished for less than 1.5 hours so far. Things might look impossible for the other teams, but things can change fast, and every single cast can mean a new top fish for any of the teams. Ladies and gentlemen, don't miss the next episode of Perch Pro 2016. Make sure to subscribe to Canal Gratis to get access to the best high-quality fishing videos on YouTube. Thanks for watching. See the final episode of Perch Pro before everyone else, together with the competing Perch Pro team in a house-shaking Hard Rock Cafe on Friday, February the 5th. Get an exclusive ticket for $4.99, including starter, main course, and drinks. Only a limited amount of tickets are available. Follow the links to get your ticket right now.